Hey, good morning, guys. Okay, I guess we're doing this for the rest of the year, huh? Okay, let's go back to World War II, and where we are is Germany's surrounded, and we're about to win, and in the very last month of the war in Europe, three deaths occur within about 2 weeks of each other. Franklin Roosevelt, the president, dies. He was elderly. He had been elected four times. Roosevelt dies. Then Mussolini dies in Europe and in Italy. I'll talk about that as well. And then finally, you know, the story behind the death of Hitler. There's some conspiracy theories that he may have escaped or something. But from what I believe and from what the history shows us, that Hitler died in Germany in an underground bunker while he was trying to run the war from his capital of Berlin, Germany. So let's start with Franklin Roosevelt's death. And when Franklin Roosevelt died, it was really a shock to everybody. He had been president for, you know, over 12 years. He was just starting his fourth presidency. And the nation was stunned. He had gotten America through the Great Depression, and it looked like World War II was about to wrap up in Europe. So this is something that I'd like you to see a clip of. It shows the emotions of the country at the time, and you know, he was a great president, and he's remembered here by these clips. So unfortunately, he didn't get to see World War II end, but he knew it was getting close.
The National Broadcasting Company humbly asks admission to your home in this, our hour of national sorrow.
Crowds are lining Constitution Avenue from here to the White House.
Many an American is standing with us today. All the soldiers and servicemen in the crowd stand firmly at attention. And now
the caisson will start its solemn, sorrowful procession through Washington.
On April 14th, 1945, America bids farewell to President Franklin Delano Roosevelt, the man who has led the country for the past 13 years.
At a time like this, words are inadequate. The world knows it has lost a heroic champion of justice and freedom. In his infinite wisdom, Almighty God has seen fit to take from us a great man who loved and was beloved by all humanity.
For the past 4 years, President Roosevelt steadfastly guided America through the war. During his presidency, the Allies have succeeded in containing the infectious spread of Hitler's armies and are now closing in on Berlin.
Okay, let's talk about Mussolini. No, it didn't end well. Okay, so Mussolini is in Italy and the Americans arrive and they start traveling up Italy, and Mussolini makes a daring escape with the help of Hitler to an area in northern Italy where the Nazis were still helping the Italians. Mussolini tries to get to Germany, and he's in a transport of Germans, and he's in the back of a truck, and he's with a bunch of his friends and his girlfriend and everything like that, and he's at the border to get into Switzerland, and Italian partisans, these are people who flipped and turned to help us when we got to Italy. They stopped the convoy, and they were going to let the Germans through, but they searched, and in the very back of a truck, hiding under a helmet, was Mussolini. And when they had everybody come out and they looked at him, he was recognizable, and they got him, him and his girlfriend and a bunch of people. Now, what happened after that's a little bit uncertain, but it's believed that he tried to escape, and they shot him and then shot everybody else that was with him. Here's what we have, and this is pretty gruesome. They took his body to the city of Milan in Italy, which is the closest city in northern Italy, where he was captured. And they presented the bodies there on display on the ground, and Italian people started coming out, and it got out of control. They actually started kicking the bodies and spitting on them, and well, it wasn't good. And a guy in Italy said, "Hey, come over here to my gas station and bring the bodies there." And they hung them up upside down, and people were starting to be able to get a better view because there were so many crowds, and there's footage here that you're going to see of the bodies upside down. And I guess I could describe what happened to Mussolini kind of like this. Pinata. The Italians were extremely emotional and upset about what Mussolini had put their country through, and started punching and hitting and throwing rocks and everything, and it was terrible. It scared the heck out of Hitler as far as what might happen to him. So I'm going to show you the clip of Mussolini, and like I said, it's gruesome, but it's history. And this is what happened to the first of the three dictators: Hitler, Mussolini, and Tojo in Japan. So here you go.
Milan was in a state of the wildest excitement at about this time, for partisans had just killed Mussolini. The bodies of the ex-dictator, his mistress, and fellow fascists were left lying in the square, and the enraged Italians took the opportunity of kicking them and flinging rubbish on them. Firemen were called in to disperse the mob, who were by now, perhaps a trifle overexcited. The final ghastly scene was the hanging of the bodies upside down outside a petrol station. Well, at least it's a warning to all remaining fascists everywhere.
All right, let's talk about the death of Hitler. It's 1945, and Hitler is in his capital of Berlin, Germany, and he's underground. He built this amazingly large bunker underground. Here's a little cutaway of it. It's kind of like a, you know, multi-roomed underground concrete structure. And he and his associates and generals and other people that are protecting him have been living there for about 30 days, and he's trying to run the war. The Russians are closing in on the city of Berlin, and he's in trouble, and he's hoping maybe for, you know, a final rally from his soldiers to maybe, you know, protect him and to push the Russians back, but it's not going to work. Hitler decides two things at the end of his life. One is to marry, and he marries this woman named Eva Braun. She was his girlfriend, and there's footage of them, and they got married in the bunker, and then both of them decided to take their lives. And what do we know about this? Well, here's something that I do want to show you. The last picture ever taken of Hitler, he comes out of the bunker, and it's kind of like in downtown Germany. And here's a picture of him shaking hands with soldiers defending Germany. These guys are younger than you. And, you know, congratulating them. They were known as the Hitler Youth. Here's another picture of a movie clip that sort of reenacted this. And then he goes in the bunker, and he's never seen again by anybody outside. What ends up happening, though, is Hitler does say some final goodbyes. And I'll show you a clip of Hitler saying some final goodbyes to different people. Here's one thing we do know. There was a young woman who was probably only about 18 at the time, hired as Hitler's secretary. She escapes and survives. And her mostly gives an account of what happened. And it's a story that has been told, you know, several times in movies and things like that. I'll show you a movie clip of this goodbye scene where he and his wife are both, you know, meeting the people most important to him. And then they'll go into Hitler's room and kill themselves. But here's this scene first.
Sie sind die tapferste Mutter im Reich.
Mein Führer, Sie machen mich zur glücklichsten Frau Deutschlands. Grüßen Sie mir mein schönes Bayern.
Okay, so Hitler was afraid of getting the Mussolini treatment and didn't want his body to be found. It's also believed he suffered from Parkinson's disease, which is where your hands shake and stuff like that. And although he wanted to shoot himself, he also took poison. And it's believed that he was given something called cyanide and that he bit down on the cyanide and shot himself. The thing is, we have no, you know, footage of that. He was in a room with his girlfriend, and when you'll see in this next clip, they hear this gunshot, and there's actually a family with some kids living there as well. They hear this gunshot, and from kind of like a witness point of view, they go in there and they see what was left. And then you'll see what happened to his body. It was taken upstairs and outside. You know, the Russians are bombing the city and there's explosions everywhere, but they prepared a grave. And in that grave are Hitler and his remains, as well as his girlfriend. And it's kind of creepy scene, you know. So his body was recovered by Russians, but it was burned beyond recognition. And, you know, some people will still believe that he somehow managed to escape, but I don't. And the evidence and the facts point to that not happening. So here's, you know, that this scene from Hitler's suicide and the remains being taken out and burned. It's pretty creepy.
Das ist lustig, wenn es so donnert.
So? Wieso denn?
Uns kann hier nichts passieren, oder?
Das stimmt.
Reichsleiter, es ist passiert.
Ich melde, der Führer ist tot.
Bist du wahnsinnig? Wegen deinem Scheißbenzin sind da draußen paar...
Erich, sei lieber still.
All right, so there you go. Three deaths all occurring within about 2 weeks toward the end of World War II. So, you know, check it out. There's a movie about Hitler's death. There's actually several. One I've seen, it's in German, but it's called Downfall. Very, very good. And it kind of chronicles the whole 30 days at the end of Hitler's life. But there are other, you know, stories and stuff as well. Okay, here's what I want you to do. All right, first of all, finish your World War II quiz. Secondly, I've posted at the bottom of this assignment a Google form. It's more about how things are going with class. It's not content, but please fill that out. And then I've had some links as well that you can look at if you're interested in this stuff. I've explored this on my own and really learned a lot. There's a tremendous amount of information out there, and it would be interesting, you know, if you had some extra time to look at some of this stuff. Okay, I'll be back tomorrow, and what we're going to talk about is Japan, because we got one enemy done. We got Hitler in Italy, you know, mostly Hitler, done, and now we got to beat the Japanese. And that's going to take a while, and it's going to be tough. So that's where we'll be tomorrow. Okay, guys, I know we're in this to the end, and I'm going to be there for you, and please watch these videos. And just find like a quiet place where you can listen to this stuff and just try to absorb it, because it does come back again in high school, and I want you to be successful. So feel free to email or do whatever you need to do to contact me to get things done, okay? All right, we'll talk again tomorrow. All right, bye.